Greetings and blessed day to you once again, people of God, is the Revelator once again, and hoping the grace and mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ is with you. Now, before we enter into today's presentation, I just want to give you a brief recap of what we covered last time. Last time, we covered quite a number of presentations, but to be more relevant, we covered the ghost demon in two separate presentations, which was part one and two. And in part one, we explained about the dead man spirit and explained how the ghost demon can represent the dead, and explained about the realms of the dead in the ghost demon, which was the part two. I explained many diversities of death which the ghost demon ushers and is a representative once again inside those realms of death. And today I want to take you into the third segment, which is now the ghost demon part three. And inside the ghost demon part three, I want to talk about the underworld captivity. Child of God, once again I'm praying and asking the Holy Spirit that he may guide you in the deep knowledge, the wisdom of the Holy Spirit. Let us get into the book of Jonah, chapter 1, verse 1. I'm going to take you through this passage throughout, and then we are going to be executing the revelation that is behind the ghost demon part 3, which is now the underworld captivity. In Jonah chapter 1 verse 1, now the word of the Lord came unto Jonah the son of Amittai, saying, arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and cry against it, for their wickedness is come up before me. The word of the Lord clearly comes to Jonah, who is a prophet, and instructs him to go to Nineveh. But because there was another voice that was calling Jonah, Jonah decided to board a ship that was heading for Tarshish. The voice of the Lord has instructed that there are souls that need the word, souls that need to be won for the kingdom in Nineveh. And for some reason, Jonah, who is a prophet, who has always abided by the word of the Lord, somehow then decides to take another route, which was not even in the program which God had assigned him. And Jonah rose up and fled unto Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. Why? Because the moment that he fled to Tarshish, he also fled away from the presence of God. That is exactly what happens when you are given an instruction by a man of God and you decide to do something which is different. You don't flee away from the man, but you also flee away from the man of God. You also flee away from God. But the Lord sent out a great wind into the sea, and there was a mighty tempest in the sea, insomuch that the ship was almost broken. Then the mariners were afraid and cried out, every man unto his God, and they cast forth the wares that were in the ship unto the sea to lighten the ship. Why? Because they assumed that the reason why the ship wanted to sink was because they were carrying a lot of heavy luggage. Yet that was not the case. There was someone that was inside that ship who had fled away from the presence of God, who did not want to do the work of God, who had other agendas that don't concern the work of God. And now God was following him. This is what I've always said to disciples, that you have a choice to choose that today you no longer want to do the work of God, but the Lord will follow you even after you have made that choice on your own. And they threw the wares inside the ship, hoping that the ship would be stable, and assuming that the luggage that was inside the ship was behind the instability that was causing the ship to be moved by the strong waves. Then the mariners were afraid and cried, every man unto his God, and cast forth their wares that were in the ship into the sea to lighten it. But Jonah was gone down into the sides of the ship, and he lay and was fast asleep. So the shipmaster came unto him and said, the shipmaster, after having realized that they had done everything, they had thrown even their business products, their luggage, their wares into the sea, and there was nothing that was changing, the shipmaster went down to the basement and asked Jonah, who was sleeping, and said, what do you mean, O you sleeper? Arise and call upon your God, if so be that God will think upon us. Can't you see that we perish? And they said, everyone to his fellow, come, let us cast lots, that we may know for whose cause the evil is upon us. So they cast lots, and the lot fell upon Jonah. If you have fled away from the presence of God, there is something that is going to follow you, which is mysterious. Every trouble that happens is going to point a finger at you. You are going to be found guilty. You are going to be blamed. Why? Because you have ran away from the assignment that God has given you, and everything around you will pinpoint you. So they cast lots, and they fell upon Jonah. Then said they unto him, tell us, we pray thee, for whose cause is this evil come upon us? What is your occupation? And where do you come from? And what is your country? And what people do you come from? And he said unto them, I am a Hebrew. I fear the Lord, the God of the heaven, which made the sea and the dry land. Jonah actually has the nerve, the capacity, the audacity to open his mouth and tell these men that I serve the Lord that made the sea and the dry land. Yet he fled away from the presence of God and boarded a ship that was going to use the sea of the Lord. He escaped the dry land, which was created by God. Then these men, they were exceedingly afraid and said unto him, why have you done this? Why? Because the men of that era understood spiritual things. You'd realize that these men were not even believers, but the moment that they heard that Jonah had fled away from the presence of God, they immediately asked him, why have you done this? Why have you ran away from the presence of your God? They knew and understood the submission under God, to the extent that though they don't believe in the same God that Jonah believes in, but they questioned Jonah to question him why he had ran away from the presence of his God. For the men knew that Jonah had fled away from the presence of the Lord because he had told them. Then they said unto him, what shall we do with you, seeing that the sea is fighting us and it's continuously raging? What shall we do so that the sea may be calm unto us? For the sea rode and was tempestuous. And he said unto them, take me up and cast me forth into the sea, so that the sea may be calm unto you. For I know that for my sake this great tempest is upon you. Nevertheless, the men rowed hard to bring it to land, but they could not, for the sea rode, and it continuously fought against them. What is happening here is these men, they tried by all means to avoid throwing Jonah into the sea. They didn't want the blood of anyone to be on their hands, but they did not understand that this was no longer a matter of men. This was now a matter between Jonah and God, and the only way that they could save themselves was to release Jonah out of that ship. Wherefore they cried unto the Lord and said, "We beseech thee, O Lord, we beseech, let us not perish for this man's life, and lay not up the innocent blood upon our hands." So they took up Jonah and cast him into the sea, and the sea ceased from her raging. Then the men feared the Lord exceedingly, and offered a sacrifice unto the Lord, and made vows. I need you to understand that the reason why these men also went through this, yet this matter is quite evident that it was a matter that was against Jonah, is because also the Lord wanted to win the men that were inside that ship. Why? Because inasmuch as they were businessmen that had products that lost their cargo, their ways, and threw into the water. These men, they did not believe in God. They believed in the God of the sea. I remember explaining this in one presentation, which was concerning the marine demons, that the men that were inside this ship, they believed in the God of the sea. So God wanted to win also the men that were inside this ship. Now, Jonah is thrown into the sea, swallowed by the sea. And Jonah is swallowed by a fish. And for 3 days and three nights, he was in the belly of the fish. This is where I represent the part three of the demon, the ghost that operates from this realm, not only from this realm, but also from the underworld. This is where I reveal the mystery of the underworld captivity. Jonah is now inside the belly of the fish. But I need you to understand something. The actual reason why God has allowed these men to throw Jonah into the sea is because there is something that Jonah needs to learn after having fled away from the presence of the Lord. So I'm going to take you to Jonah chapter 2 verse 1. Then you hear the prayer that was done by Jonah. Then Jonah prayed unto the Lord his God out of the fish's belly. Out of this fish's belly. There is a prayer that was done by Jonah out of the fish's belly. This prayer that was done by Jonah out of the fish's belly is now a confession, a testimony. It regards and represents the things that transpired the moment that he was thrown into the sea. What people only understand, all those that are readers of the scriptures, is that Jonah was swallowed by a fish, and the next thing, it vomited him. Why? Because those are preachers without revelation, and I don't blame them. And Jonah is now making a confession out of the fish's belly, meaning that this is after he was already spit out. But there's something that happened which was more than Jonah being in the belly of the fish. Why? Because what was swallowed by the fish was the body of Jonah, not the soul. And I'm going to prove to you that Jonah actually died while he's in the belly of the fish. And Jonah said, "I cried by the reason of mine affliction unto the Lord, and he heard me. Out of the belly of hell cried I, and you heard my voice." Jonah is now talking about his experience while he's in hell. He has descended to the lower parts of hell. It means Jonah actually died while he's inside the belly of the fish. What remained inside the belly of the fish was the lifeless body. And the soul descended to the lower parts of hell. How does the soul of a prophet descend to the lower parts of hell? I have the evidence. It's because Jonah had disobeyed the Lord. What I believe is that every soul that is going to depart from this realm is supposed to ascend, not descend. But if your soul descends, it's quite evident that your soul is descending because there is disobedience, there is some form of disobedience that you have committed. And Jonah descends to the belly of hell. This is no longer about the belly of the fish. Most of you know about the belly of the fish. And Jonah is saying all this as a confession and presenting his testimony. And says, for you had cast me into the deep, in the midst of the seas. The floods compassed me about. All thy billows and all thy waves passed over me. He talks about all thy billows, all thy waves. Then said, I am cast out of thy sight, yet I will look again towards the holy temple. The waters compassed me about, even to the soul. Why does he talk about the waters compassing him even unto the soul? Do the waters reach the soul? This is no longer about the waters. This is about the underworld that had swallowed Jonah. That had swallowed Jonah. The depth closed all around me. The winds were wrapped around my head. Why does he talk about the winds wrapping around his head if he was only inside the belly of the fish? I went down to the bottoms of the mountains. Why does he talk about the bottoms of the mountains if he was inside the belly of the fish? The earth with their bars was about my life forever. Yet you brought up my life from corruption, O my Lord God. Then Jonah says, when my soul fainted within me, I remembered the Lord. This is the part that is quite evident, that gives clear evidence that Jonah had died inside the belly of the fish, and his soul went deep down into hell and Hades. And when the soul reaches deep down hell and Hades, it is delivered by the messenger of death. And the messenger of death delivers the body, which is the soul, which is the immortal spirit, unto death. And death puts the soul deep down in hell and Hades. Now, when you go deep down hell in Hades, there are cages, there are prisons, which are defined as hell in a cell. Right? I need you to understand this. Earlier on, in a deliverance session, I exposed the ghost demon. And when it manifested, it didn't want to confess that it was the ghost demon. And it confessed inside a believer, inside a disciple. And that disciple had been possessed by a ghost demon that had earlier came and stole his spiritual body in the middle of the night. And his soul was descended with deep down into hell and Hades. And had this believer, this disciple, not been one with an assignment which the Lord wants him to do, in as much as Jonah had also an assignment that God wanted him to do in Nineveh, he would have died. Why? Because as the demon explains in the deliverance session, it says this disciple was hanged deep down in hell and Hades, and the ghost demon descended with the spiritual body deep down to the pit of hell. And this young man was rescued by the Lord's generals that ascend in the realms and dimensions of the spirit by virtue that he has not finished his assignment. Now Jonah is deep down there, but I need you to understand that the ghost demon is now in charge. He has taken the body, and the only one that he can deliver Jonah out of the pit of hell is God. Why? Because this matter is no longer about just repenting. This now needs the Lord to deliver Jonah. Why? Because Jonah, you have not finished your assignment. I want you to know that the reason why Jonah actually fled from the presence of the Lord, the ghost demon was already operating all that while. It is the reason which causes Jonah to be thrown into the sea, and he is swallowed by Bermuda Triangle. After being swallowed by Bermuda Triangle hands over the soul of Jonah to the deep pit of hell, and Jonah is chained and imprisoned. There are souls that are imprisoned deep down there. I once had a vision that I shared, and you can check for it on YouTube, which is called My Vacation to Hell, where I get into a lift, one of the fastest elevators that take me deep downwards, and I go there as the deep undercover to go and investigate what happens down there. What happens down there is that there is the spirit of death who is the guardian in the land of the living, and deep down in hell there are demons that represent hell and Hades, and there is the shadow ghost demon. The shadow ghost demon is a demon that represents all the ghost demons that enter those that are about to die. And the graveyard spirit hands over the spirit that is about to get deceased to the shadow demon, which is the ghost demon. And the ghost demon hands over the spirit to the spirit of death. And one is sacrificed deep down to the underworld, and he is held as a captive. This is the part in which Apostle Paul talks about Jesus descending to the lower parts and delivering the captives who were captivated. Jonah has been delivered out of the pit of hell. And Jesus, in one scripture, says, as Jonah was in the belly of Sheol, so shall the Son of Man. He was talking about not his ascension, but his descending down to the pit of hell, where he would go and deliver the souls that are captivated by the ghost demon, those that were delivered by the spirit of death. Child of God, I'm here once again in the ghost demon part 3, the underworld captivity. I'm here to say Jesus is ready to give you life once again. Jesus wants you to make your way straight with him. He wants you to find life after this life. He wants you to ascend. He doesn't want you to descend. Jesus doesn't want you to disobey as Jonah did. Child of God, I speak this very day with the evidence of a soul that I prayed for, who was taken deep down as Jonah to the lower pits of hell, inside the hell in a cell where he was hanged, and he is delivered by the Lord, by God's generals. Child of God, I myself as the revelator, I've gone deep down there as an undercover agent, and I don't want to go back there because I saw the wrath that is down there. I'm praying right now that the Lord finds mercy and forgives you for all the sins that you have committed, and you also give your life to Jesus Christ, so that when your time comes, you ascend to the realms of the spirit, where there is afterlife and eternal life, in the name of Jesus.
This is the year I breathe. This is the year I breathe. Your holy presence living in me. This is my day, bread. This is my day, bread. Your spoken to me, and I I'm desperate for you. love.